Hey guys, it's Maymay. Can you see us and hear us? I'm not sure if you can or not, so let me know. I got Vinny in the room. He's not speaking today.
Oh, what's up, everybody?
Vinny's here.
I'm just trying to get your live video to come up, and it's not coming up for me.
He's going to get signed in so he can help with comments and questions. A couple things before we get started. Make sure when you have a question, you type it in all caps so we can see it. That's not yelling. That's just so we can see it. Our troll patrol is here. Look at all our moderators with their wrenches. And I don't know why some of them don't have their wrench, but if you are a moderator, say hi. Maybe put a thumbs up or something and let us know. And today, we got a couple things. We're going to do two baskets. Remember this we talked about last week? We're going to do this little slatted basket, which I made a little different. And I'll tell you why as we go. I didn't do everything I did to the big one on this one, so we'll get to that. And then this little guy, which I showed you last week, we're going to make it too. And do you notice these precious, adorable little Haribo in here? If you follow me on Instagram, and if you don't, why not? Go follow me. It's Maymay Made It on Instagram. You would have seen that my sweet hubby ate my craft projects.
Lord, how do you keep bringing that up?
So I showed a photo where Vince had eaten. I bought two of these and he ate them. And it was so funny. But my sweet moderator, just hold on a second for this. My sweet moderator, Tanya, hold on. Here we go. Tanya Rose sent me this. You ready for this? Look at all of these. So we're going to have plenty of gummy bears to use for our projects today.
We really don't need anybody else to send this in.
No, we got so many, y'all. We got these like this, and we got a 5-pound bag from Renee Stevens. So funny. We got a 5-pound bag of Haribo. And hold on, I'm not done. I got to show you something else. Let me put these up. Dana, when she came to visit us, wait. I'm trying. She brought me some more gummy bears, so hold on a second. She couldn't find the small packs of gummy bears, so she brought me this pack, right? But then she also brought me these little guys, which are gummy lifesavers. And I'm happy to say and sad to say at the same time, this is the last pack of them. But look how cute these would be. These are...
And it's not Vinny's fault.
No, he didn't eat all these. These are bunnies and eggs. So like, oops, I want to put this in here too. So I'm going to fold the ends down and just kind of put this into our basket. And then look, you can put little bunnies and eggs in there too. Super cute. Super cute. You guys spoil us and take care of us big time. So we have lots of Haribos. But look how cute the little Haribos are in there. I think they're so cute, these little guys. So, all right, we're making them today. Everybody ready to make a tiny basket? How about you, Vinny?
Absolutely.
You're ready to make a tiny basket?
Let's get this thing done.
So, the tiny basket, if you remember, where's the big one? Oh, you can't reach that, can you? Nope, let me see if I can. If I fall off the stool, you'll know it because you'll hear it. This is the original one we did, and we found this from a blog post. We made this a way while back. And yes, that's a term. Then on Tuesday, I made this one double its size almost. And then actually, it was double its size, I think. And then today, we're going to make one with 6x6 paper. Okay? So here's what you'll need. You'll need one sheet of 6x6. This is cardstock. Ugh. Oh, no. Can I show this?
Yeah, we don't have any of them, but you can
There's
show
some
it.
In the store, though?
It's in the store.
Okay. I'm using this paper pack called Summer Party. This paper pack is discontinued, and we got a handful in the store, and it is so cute. So this is the paper pack I'm working from on this basket today. Super cute. Okay. 6x6 cardstock here. Then you're going to need, and I don't love this. You know I don't love working in these numbers, but for this basket, it worked well. Then you're going to need these pieces that are 5/8 of an inch, okay, and I'll show you that on the cutting board in a minute. You will need 12 of these. They're 5/8 wide by 2 1/4 tall, okay? So I've got my 12 all ready to go. And then you're going to need one more piece, which is this guy for the handle, and it is 5/8 of an inch by 6. Don't stress about the measurements. We're going to link a blog post below that's going to have all the information. Just so y'all know, that's something that our sweet Tamitha does for me. She writes our blog post now, and she gets all our links done for us, and it's so nice. This is what I had left over from two pieces of 6x6 cardstock. This piece is going to be used. That's my one piece. This was my second piece of cardstock. That's all that was left over. Let's get to making. All right. When you're cutting your little strips, I want to give you a tip, okay? So this is a piece of my scrap. You see what I did right here? I took a piece of painter's tape, and because I'm going to be doing 5/8 of an inch, which can be a little confusing, half an inch is here. You can see that tall line. That's half an inch. 5/8 is 1/8 of an inch bigger. So what I did was I put a piece of tape here, and then I could just butt up my cardstock to that tape and just quickly over and over know I'm getting the right measurement. And I do this a lot, especially if I'm working with kids, because if kids are not sure about where to measure here, put that tape down there and it lets them know where to line their paper up to. Just a tip for you guys. All right, to the scoreboard, Batman.
Batman, really?
That's what I say sometimes. Can I say sometimes? Okay, tools, please. Here's our embossing tool. So, you know I could use the little one. Where is my little one? Because then it would be all the way in screen. Should I search more than that length of time for it? Maybe not. It should be right here, but I don't see it. Okay, scoring. Here's the thing. This is going to be the outside of my basket. This is going to be the inside of my basket. I thought these were really cute. This one is so easy to make. We're making the slat basket first. You're going to score this one at 2 inches and at 4 inches. You're going to turn it and score at 2 inches and at 4 inches. Super easy on your scoring. I have something stuck to me here. Okay.
Connie asks, why do you have a black line down the middle of your scoreboard?
If I ever want to do an angled score mark, like if I wanted to score from one end to the other here, I would line this up at the 6 inch, but because I have that black line drawn, I can then see down here and know I'm on the right spot, and I could score this at an angle. Or if you're just trying to score somewhere specific on a page, you're able to see the top and the bottom and know you're lined up correctly. There you go. Good question, though. All right. Another tip. There's going to be plenty of time for chatting, too, once I get to the assembly part. I just want to kind of get everybody through that. Here's what we're going to do here. I'm going to fold this and crease it before I do any slicing, okay? So I'm just going to fold this guy in and crease on all of our score lines. And truth of the matter is, it's just 4 score lines, and you're just going to work yourself around the page and do it. Anything I need to know?
Nope. Everybody's answering questions as they're being asked, unless I ask you.
You can butt in at any time. We talked about this earlier. I'm like, you can butt in because I can always make sure I explain things. Okay, the beauty of this basket is that each of these squares we just made are all the same size. All you need to do is decide front and back, okay? So this is going to be the front of my basket. This will be the back. So now we need to slice. Here we go. So, I'm going to come to this score line, and I'm going to cut to that first cross section. This is the same thing we did with the big basket, and it's the same thing we did with purses. Remember that? Purses went crazy. Did you know that, Vince?
Everybody was making purses.
Yep.
I saw lots and lots of pictures of purses.
Now, opposite end of it, I'm going to slice. On the other side, the same thing. We are going to go back and do one little thing, but I've learned to do this in steps because it gets confusing. So here's basically what we've cut. I like to bend this out for you to see that, okay? Now I'm going to try to explain something. If this makes sense, I want you to tell me even you understood it.
Oh, that's scary.
Okay. When we fold up a box and we just cut these straight slices like this, when we bring these in, where this area here touches this bottom, we can get some resistance. And what I mean by that is, if we didn't cut a perfect straight line and we push this here and we try to close this up, oh, a perfect example, we can get a little piece that's not perfectly square, okay? You with me so far?
So far.
We're gonna get rid of that problem by taking out this little angled slice right here. What this simple little angle does is now, instead of having the bulk on this end of the page, when I bring it up, I can now move that around a tiny bit to line this up nice and straight. Did that make sense? Because I took weight out of this area. Did you understand it?
I did.
If you understood it, I feel like I did it well, because you don't ever do card projects, right?
I do not do very many card projects. We do have a question about the, Destiny asked, are these SVG files For the Cricut or the Cameo?
This is not. I have not made any files for this because they're just straight cuts. And to me, I can cut these faster with my board than I can. I mean, unless I'm making like 50 or 60. But they're literally just rectangles. That's all this whole project is. All right, let's close up this basket real quick. And the way you're going to do it is bring these two guys in and glue it together like that, like a box. Okay, so let's do that real quick. Where's my glue? Here it is. I heard you say start to talk.
Yes. We're getting questions about the Stamp Perfect product. And just so everybody knows.
I'm not going to discuss the Stamp Perfect product.
Okay. Well, we're not going to be carrying it.
Yeah, but I don't want to get, that's not my information to share. So I didn't tell you that ahead of time. I apologize. All right. So now, but he is right. Now we can tell you that we won't be carrying it anymore. So yeah, you were right about that.
Okay. We will not be carrying it anymore. And, I got the green light because there are people are asking about art glitter glue. I got the green light on art glitter glue yesterday and we have an order coming in and it's supposed to be here tomorrow. And as soon as that order arrives, you will be able to purchase art glitter glue again.
Yeah, we need to clarify that because it gets confusing with art glitter glue. By the way, guys, I'm just closing these up, okay? It gets confusing. We could only ship art glitter glue to places where it was not 40 degrees or lower between us.
So at night.
Yeah. So we had, like, the lows didn't drop there, okay? So some people were confused and they thought we were saying that they could, if like somebody messaged us and said, I hate to say it, but spring has sprung. I should be able to get my glue. And we understand, but it was still like below 40 between us to get to them. But now they're telling us the company has given us the green light to ship. So that's a whole different ball game. That means we don't have to wait anymore. Did you notice something I did different on this basket? I want to see if anybody noticed. I went ahead and closed this one up before putting on my slats. In the other baskets, I didn't do that. There's a reason I did it on this one. I tried doing it the other way, and it was so tiny and kind of fiddly that I didn't enjoy the process. So I've not tried doing it this way, but I thought I would together with you guys. But you can do it the way we did the other basket, but I'm going to do it a little bit different.
Okay, we got a question from Dee asking, why did you cut this one different? Or did you cut it different?
I don't think I cut it different. I don't think I did. Tell me what I did different, because I'm not sure. What I'm doing here is taking those little slat pieces, and I'm just giving them a little bend to make this go easier. And really, I just found for this particular project, it was a little fiddly the way I was trying to do it, like the big one where I would put the slats on before I folded it. But you can totally do whatever works for you. That's the beauty of crafting. Do what you want. Do what you want. Oh, I missed what she was saying. There was a big comment, but you probably saw it. Okay, so now, did you see what I did different? What did she say yet?
No, she has not said different.
Okay.
Yeah, Betty, if your temperatures are below, 40 at night, we're not supposed to ship it to you. Now, our people at Art Glitter Glue said they've checked places, and it's not. But if you want to order art glitter glue, at this point, I can ship it, but I appreciate you saying it's still too cold in your neck of the woods. But if you want to order it, I can hold it till you say, okay, it's not cold anymore, or something like that. We'll figure that out.
All right, I'm going to work two sides at a time just so I don't stick this to my work surface. So, because I'm doing this a little bit different than the last time, I just wanted to try this and see how much harder this was. It can be done the other way, okay? You cut on four different sides of those, not two of the same. I cut on four different sides.
Yes,
I did that one differently because I did it like the blog post. But to be honest, I think you could do it the same way. But I was mimicking that blog post, and that's how they had done it.
Laura was still working on round blocks with a supplier. The first sample they sent us was not good. So we're working on that.
We're trying. See, to me, this smaller basket is so much easier to do like this. You guys, I did it the other way. And it's so much easier to put it in your hand like this and do this. So I'm going to suggest you do it this way. But do what you want. Nobody feel like you have to do it like I tell you just because I said to do it that way. Everybody, you'd be surprised how many times I see somebody do something a better way than me. The Art Glitter Glue says sold out. They have to call in to order till Friday.
Yes.
I don't know if you said that part.
I probably did not.
So see how I'm putting the little slats on? We're still going to get the same look. I'm just not doing it exactly the same as I did last time. Like I said, it was so fiddly to put it together. Is that a word?
Okay, Terrence says, what's the difference in sticky tape than if I was to use a tape runner?
All tapes are different. All tapes have a different, they almost should be rated. I wish they had like our tape rating, like super strong and this strong and that strong, you know, but they don't. This particular tape is one that I have discovered that I love the price of and I love the stickiness of. But there are different tapes like this. Now, tape runner tape is typically not as strong. For example, like ATG is not as strong as this. And since I found this tape, I never even use my ATG anymore. My ATG's in a closet somewhere, put away. Are you shocked by that, Vince?
It used to be one of your favorite tools.
Yeah, and since Art Glitter Glue and this sticky tape, I never mess with it anymore.
The sticky tape is much stronger than like the tape runners, right?
Yeah, this one will even hold fabric. That's how I learned about it. When Jamie introduced it to me, it was because it would hold fabric. And I was like, what? She was like, it sure will. Go check it out. This is also the same product that our full sheets are made out of. So if we're using our full sheets of adhesive, same product.
And that's why we're not making Art Glitter Glue live till tomorrow, because we have a big shipment coming in tomorrow. So.
Oh, I thought you were giving the green light for Friday. You're saying your shipment's not here till tomorrow.
Right. I mean, I have some, but I don't want to put some in and then not.
Because some people might want to order multiple bottles. I'm excited to be able to sell it again. And I know Amanda's excited too. She's loved helping you guys. But can you imagine how many phone calls she's done? Art Glitter Glue has been the thing. The thing.
We have a customer from Germany asking if she can order it per email. When it's out of stock.
Look what I did, y'all. I messed myself up. I'm just going to take this off and redo it. Yeah, I think probably. Now, I'd be concerned because I'm not sure we can ship to Germany, can we? What's the temperature like between us and Germany?
I don't have any idea.
But if they gave you the green light, it was for everywhere, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you wait till tomorrow to order, you can just order it from the website without having to go through us at all. Okay, our slats are on. Super cute, right? Tiny, tiny. See how tiny? Okay, let me throw some stuff in the trash real quick.
Art Glitter Glue does not come with the fine metal tip. That is a separate order. And yes, Tracy, we do carry sticky tape in our store. We have the 5mm and the 8mm and 50-yard rolls. And the 8mm came back in.
Okay, I'm putting a little bit of sticky tape on the end of my 5/8" by 6" piece, which, as you guessed, is the handle.
And Rhonda, Art Glitter Glue is a little expensive, but you use so little of it at a time, it lasts a long time. It's well worth it.
Okay, I removed the backer. So this is my handle, okay? Now what I'm going to do is pick one side, and I'm lining that handle up with a slat. You don't have to do that. I just think it looks cute in the end. It kind of matches. And then we're only going to bend, we're not going to fold, and we're going to bring it over and match the same on the other side. I'm kind of doing this fast because this is the third tutorial that I've done on the baskets. So I think if you watch any of those, you've got this part down pat. I really do think that putting these slats on afterwards was much easier. We need one more thing. We need to make it pretty. So I'm going to put some ribbon on. So I'm going to run some sticky tape around. Just like so. I got that crooked. And I'm going to run it all the way around, and then I'm going to run it all the way around the bottom, too. I wish I could see questions. I feel like I'm not helping you guys at all, but...
The last question is, can Maymay do a video using the Nuvos soon?
That's a good idea. I think I've used... Didn't I do a live with them? I don't remember. On Facebook? I don't remember. It's been a while, hasn't it?
I can send Art Glitter Glue to Germany, but... I'd rather not take orders by email for that, because you can't pay for it by email. So you need to do that from the
website. Just do it Friday when it's back in stock. That'll be the easiest way to do that, I think.
Yes, Tina, if it's blowing snow where you are, please don't order art glitter glue.
That's a good tip.
Because it will arrive to you looking like cottage cheese.
Hey, if, what is that thing? Oh, crud. The frozen bubbles. Have y'all seen that where people say if you live in an area below freezing and you go outside and you blow bubbles, they'll freeze? If bubbles will freeze outside your house when you blow them, please don't order art glitter glue. Is that a good rule? Just being silly.
Does Maymay recommend that brand of double-sided tape than Score Pal?
Over Score Tape, probably. I used to use Score Tape. I don't use it anymore. I use this one. I just like this one. Like I said, I was introduced to it by a friend. Jamie at Craft Chameleon introduced me to it, and I've loved it ever since, and I just use it. I've used Score Pile in the past, or Score Tape in the past, but I like this one.
Yeah, Susie Q, if you can throw water in the air and it makes ice, don't order our way too cold.
Thank goodness there's not something that says if you can fry an egg on the concrete, don't order it, because guess what? Yeah. Well, I guess all chocolate is that way, but we'll be there before you know it. We will be there before you know it. We'll be in the throes of summer.
Our friend from Hawaii wants to know what brand is that tape. We just call it sticky tape.
It does not have a brand. It's just called sticky tape. The one I'm using now is the 8. Is this the 8 or the 5?
Let me see. That's the 8.
Because here's the 5, right? Okay, this one's the 8. It's like a quarter of an inch. They're not, though, because they're metric. So it's just under 3/8 of an inch, and this one is just under a quarter. So the 8 is the bigger, the 5 is small. Alrighty then.
Tracy, we're still working on Vinny's Vittles. We got to get a stove. We ain't done that yet.
So I'm going to call this one done for here. You can absolutely decorate it more than that, but that shows you how to make that one, right? So do you like the small one? Does everybody like it?
Sticky tape comes in two sizes, and it comes in the 10 by 12 sheets.
Look at this, so cute.
8 millimeter, 5 millimeter, 10 by 12 sheets.
Too cute. All right, you guys like it?
I don't have a clue how much a case is.
Email us, because you can contact and we can see if we can do that. We'll just have to see if we can order it. All right. Now then, we're going to make the other one. Everybody likes it. Good. Super easy, 2 sheets of 6x6 paper, and here's what I had left. Now, I had a little bit more left because I showed you a cutting trick, but I didn't have very much of this left, and just 2 pieces. Now, let's make this little guy. Now, this is not going to be for everybody. I know this one is using the die that we carry in the store, but I want to tell you something. This same procedure will work for any die cut that you have. You're just going to build a box and then put your die cut on it. So even if you just cut out a bunny and glued it to where the basket is, you'll just have a stand-up bunny you can put candy in. So if we have a second, I might be able to show you that too. All right, so let's make this guy. For him, we're going to need, let's do this. Let that catch back up. I forgot to put this on airplane mode. Where is my mini scoreboard at? Are we back?
It looks like we are.
Okay. My phone rang, but we're back. Okay. This piece of paper... This is for the box inside the die basket. I'm calling this one the die basket because we're going to use this die for it, okay? This is 1 sheet. It is 4.5 by 3.75, all right?
Welcome, Ashley. We're glad you got your first order in today, and it'll be flown out of here pretty quick, so you'll be shocked how fast you get it.
This is going to be the outside of my basket. So I'm going to score the inside. So I'm going to lay this down here. This will be what's on the inside of my basket. With the 4.5 inch side in your scoring tool, you're going to score this at 1.25 and at 3.25. Okay? There's your first marks. Now we're going to turn this, and with the 3.75 inch side in our scoreboard, we're going to score it at 1.25 and 3. Oops, I got the wrong number there. Hold on. 1.25 and 2.5. So I'll go back and tell you those since I hiccuped. On the 4.5 inch side, 1.25, 3.25. On the 3.75 side, 1.25, 2.5. Okay? Don't worry, all those measurements will be on the blog. Let's do our scoring and folding. I keep putting stuff away, which is not like me. I can't find anything. So, all right. I'm gonna fold and crease all score lines. There's 4 of them. just like so. And then we're gonna cut just like we did a minute ago. Okay, I'm going to slice up here and I'm gonna make that V cut again that I've already explained earlier. So we're cutting right beside the front of our basket, okay? This gets really repetitive, and if you learn how to make these boxes, you kind of can do them in your sleep. You really can.
We try very hard, Tracy, to get things out as fast as possible. Usually it's the same day, if not the next business day for sure.
You think I could craft in my sleep?
Yep.
I think so too. Okay, so I've sliced this little guy just like we did the other one. We just have a bigger spot in the middle, and now it's time to glue it shut. We use a little art glitter glue on this side first and glue it in place. I chose this floral paper because the basket is see-through, and I thought it'd be pretty to have the flowers showing through the basket. Some more glue on this little piece and glue it into place. Are we having fun?
Yeah.
When Vince gets quiet, I get nervous.
Well, that's because I'm reading and then they're just flooding comments in. So
I'm like, are people mad? Are people leaving because you're quiet?
Our friend in Hawaii also asked why we don't sell die cutting and embossing machines.
I cannot sell them as cheap as you can. Okay, so let me say this. I recommend the Cuddle Bug because I love it, right? But I can't sell it as cheap as you can buy it on Cricut.com. There's no sense in me trying because I'd have to sell it at full price. And they can sell it super cheap. I didn't glue that correctly. I'm not going to stress about it. All right, we'll leave that alone. I'm not going to stress. Not going to stress. If you
Somebody
buy from...
said they want me to make a tutorial.
I want you to too.
Nope.
If you buy a
That's
Cricut...
That's not my job.
If you buy a Cuddle Bug from Cricut.com, use my code to get 15% off and free shipping. I can't beat their prices. And if you're a member of any of their clubs, you're going to get automatic other money off of things, other percents off. So, all right, A plate, C plate into the machine, B plate for the top. People ask me, how do I remember? C is for cutting, B is for embossing. You're always going to use an A and a B in your sandwich, but if you put a C in, it's for cutting. Okay, here we go. I can't afford to give the kind of discounts they give. See, they buy things, that's what people don't, I don't think everybody understands how this works. Those companies like that buy things by the hundred thousand? Is that a fair statement? I've lost my white paper. Don't know what to do with it. You know what I'm talking about, Vinny? Like, companies like Cricut or those big companies.
Bless you.
Ooh, bless you.
Excuse me. Bless you.
You always sneeze more than once.
I'm a multiple sneezer.
Anyway, those companies buy things like by the 100,000 volume and they can get them so inexpensive. But we can't do that.
Thank you, everyone.
So what we do, I had a piece of paper prep, but I've lost it. So we have to buy them at wholesale, which is not as cheap. So we don't get to offer the kind of discounts that other people do. I offer every discount I can. And sometimes even when Vinny's like, what? By the way.
Yeah, good night.
I have a magnetic cutting plate. I typically don't pick it up. I just grab this and use it. You can totally do this with your magnetic cutting plate. I just don't need it at this point. All right, cut one. There's that little basket. Let me pull it out, and then we're going to cut another one. We'll leave that sitting there for a second. And then, hey, Vinny.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm fixing to show you what this tool was actually invented for. Are you excited?
The pokey tool?
Are you excited? This is actually what it was invented for. Are you ready?
Yep.
This is a die release tool by KaiserCraft. Okay. Mm. You see how my die is in here?
Yeah.
Before I do anything, because I know you're going to tell me, there are 900 different ways to make this easier to come out. Run a dryer sheet through first. Emboss, hit this with your embossing powder tool. There's all different kinds of ways. You guys do, you do you. Here's what I do. I'm going to poke this little guy through these holes right here. Do you see that? And then you can grab it. And that is literally what this tool was invented for.
The pokey tool.
Are you excited to see that? Come on, Vin.
I mean, it's nice to see what it's made for, yes.
Now, I use it for 9,000 other things.
It also makes a great stopper for your art glitter glue.
You do use it for that. Here's one right here. Okay, we're going to cut another one. Let me poke these out real quick. These are not bad to poke out. Some people might think, oh, that's so much work. It doesn't bother me. But you can run a dryer sheet through your, or some wax paper. There's like so many different ways to prep these before. I've never done it. Y'all, so many people tell me every tip in the world. I'm a purist crafter. I just do it. I don't stress about.
Now, y'all, that tool is not called Pokey Tool in the store.
It is a Kaiser Craft dye release tool.
That's the texture term.
Yes, it does. Matter of fact, this is not a Cricut dye that I'm cutting right now. This is a Derice dye. I think Derice dyes are such good prices. That's why we carry them in the store, because I think they're excellent prices. So I'm cutting a Derice dye now. But here's what I suggest. If you ever pick up a dye and you're not sure, check out the back, because a lot of times it'll tell you. This one's actually tells you about the ProvoCraft, but here it'll tell you it'll cut on ProvoCraft, Craftwell, Quick Cut, Sizzix, Big Kick, and Big Shot. So check out what they say. What is it?
Molly says she's been watching too much Maymay. I folded my dinner napkin last night into an envelope and left it on the table.
I love it. Oh my gosh. I love it. I wish I had seen it. I'm going to clean this up just a little bit. Here, we'll pop this other one out first. I thought it was cool to show you. I got to get this out of my way off my screen. It's driving me up the wall. Okay. I thought it was cool to show you what this tool is really used for. Do you think?
Oh, yeah.
All right. So.
Mighty cool.
Let's pop these out real quick. There's also this little brush tool you can use. I'm just such. I don't know. I say I'm a purist. I have a lot of tools, but they're just simple tools. I don't really use super fancy tools. Do you think I do? I don't know. Maybe I do. All right, you have to have two of these to make this little project, okay? So there's two.
A question. Do you place cutting side of die down on the C-plate?
Okay, I got to show y'all because you're going to be like, what? I don't care which way you do it. Look at these.
Somebody commented on how scarred up yours was.
They do. It works. I don't care. Let me tell you. Watch this, Vinny. What's my theory?
It ain't got to be pretty. It's just got
to
work.
It's so it's my theory. Function. It doesn't have to be pretty. It just has to function. And these work fine. And I've had these. These are the only ones I've had for this machine for over 5 years. And see how they are? These are the only ones I use. Doesn't have to be pretty. Just has to work. Now, if you need it to be pretty, because that's some people need it to be pretty, then just make sure every time you run it through, you run it the same way. And you'll be fine. One of them will scar up, but one of them won't. Okay? All right. Now, so easy. Ready for this? Don't blink. This is easy. Art glitter glue or whatever, your glue of choice. I'm going to run a strip, just a line of art glitter glue around the top or just at the top and at the bottom, not around, just on the front. Okay?
Is there a way for you to show them how little art glitter glue you use like that?
Oh, that's a good tip. Let me bring it up for the next one and show you since I got to put this down before it dries. Then I just center this over that little box. Just like this. Needs to move closer. Oh, that'd be awesome. Okay.
Well, that's a lot of packing just to be closer.
I glued that one on the front with two strips of art glitter glue. All right, let me show you. Can you see? I shake, by the way, so you're going to see me shake. There's nothing to do about that. And this is an awkward angle, so I'm really going to shake. There's a stripe of glue there and a stripe of glue here, just
can
like
you turn
that.
Turn it sideways where they can see how little glue is on that.
How about that?
Can y'all see how little?
I gotta hurry, it's gonna dry.
The fact that you can't see anything shows you how little she uses.
And then I just put this on. Look at that. Now, I wanna show you. I made this one like 2 weeks ago because I made this before we did last week's live video. So, and that was done with the same amount of glue. Look, it's still together, nice and tight. And then you can decorate this and tie things on it, do whatever you want to do. But then look how cute these are. I love them. I love the hair bows, these little tiny hair bows. I love anything that is like tiny. I just love it. So there's that. Let's put some more hair bows in. I got plenty of them.
They ask, are you recording? Some people are having trouble with it buffing.
Buffering.
Buffering. And that is probably an internet issue on your end?
Maybe. Sometimes, I mean, it's the reason I think it is because it's running fine here. But let me tell you something. YouTube live videos always will go up. You don't have to record them. They'll go up afterwards. They just have to process So they won't be up like as soon as we hit stop, but they will be up. Yeah, this will be on YouTube for you to watch later. Look at there. Little baskets. Do you like them? Now, I decided I wanted to do like an extra segment in this show, and I want to see what you guys think. So, and you don't even know about this, I'm going to tell you.
Oh, great. Thanks for dragging me in.
We bought these, did I show you? If you saw our store tour, you would have seen that I bought these little baby bed mattress. What are they called? Baby bed.
Oh, it's just a baby bed mattress frame.
Springs. Box springs for baby. That's what they are. Box springs for baby beds. And I hung up I displayed our distress inks on them. Well, I have two extra ones, and I'm going to be putting cards that you guys send us using techniques that you either learned from me, or I would prefer that they were ones you learned from me so I can show people, but I'm not real picky about that. I'm not terribly picky. So what I thought I would do, because I've had some come in this week, and I know I've had, oh my gosh, you guys, we've had hundreds and hundreds of cards come in. Is everybody having problems? I see some people.
Several people are having problems.
Yeah, but is everybody, or is anybody watching this okay? Because if anybody's watching this okay, we're okay.
Yeah, okay. There's no problems here.
Okay, as long as some people are seeing this okay, we're okay. So I'll keep going. All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I think every Thursday, or every time we do this live show together, which I want to name, by the way.
Holy cow.
What is it?
A lot of people say I'm good.
Okay. I'm going to show you guys some cards that have come in, and then we're going to hang them in our classroom for people to get inspiration from. So I want to call this segment something. What can we call it? I don't want it to be mail call, because I think everybody does mail call, you know? What about Inspiration Corner? Or Inspiration Seconds or Minutes or whatever. So I'm going to share with you guys some, and you guys will love them. I get cards from you guys all the time, and you do amazing work. And I want to show you. So, this card I'm super excited about. But before I get too excited, I'm going to see if I can find it. Oh, why can I never put my hand on things when I want them, when I'm on a live? I can't do it. All right. This card was made by Tammy Kahn, who may be here today. I didn't look. And that's another surprise. You'll just never know when it shows up. You know what I'm saying? So, this card was made by Tammy Kahn. And it was to us. And it says on the front, look at this card now. You are God's masterpiece, Ephesians 2:10. Now, here's what I tell you. Remember when I told you guys that you could buy those little coloring cards from Walmart in that little box set, which I have somewhere right here at me, but I can't see it. I really wish I could find it. Anyway, you can color it and turn it into a card, and that's what she did. She colored that little card and then turned it into a card. So this whole piece was from that little coloring set. If you don't remember me talking about these, I promise you, we did a video, and I will have to find it for you and share it. But that's what she used there, and I love it. And she sent us a sweet little note. And so what I'll do is start adding these to our card-making racks that we're going to put outside, and I'll show you guys. All right, this one is from Miriam Zella, and there's no promises I'm ever going to say your names right. Can we say that?
I would agree.
And this is a beautiful card, and she stamped the word prayers, and then did this beautiful coloring in the corner. Look how gorgeous. Hey, Michelle, I'm glad you said that, but we might have some really good news this afternoon about those cards. We're trying. We might have some really good news. These are the cards I was telling you about. We may know this afternoon. Okay, and then this one. This one is from Andrea. Oh, I cut the name. Andrea Gingrich. And I want to show y'all something else, too. Let me cover this up. Okay. Do you see this? This is a 6x6 card, and look how much postage she had to put on there. You guys ask me that all the time. And no, it's perfectly fine, y'all. We're trying to get those cards in our store for you guys. Look how much postage she had to put on a 6x6. So, yes, you do have to pay more. But look what she sent me. Sometimes it's worth it. Look at this. Now, I have made a card similar to this before on my channel a while back. Do you see the ruffles? And the pearls. How cute is this, right? And then it opens like so. And she sent me some ATCs, which I will also hang up on our little wall out there. How cute is this, right? I just love this so much. These are adorable. If you don't know what an ATC is, I'm going to give you a real quick overview. I can't tell you all the details, but it's like this. This is called an artist trading card. And if she made up a bunch of these and she kept them with her, whenever she ran into fellow artists, you would trade these with them. Okay? So that's what they're for you to go, here's a piece of my artwork. Let me have a piece of your artwork. Look how cute. From Texas. Look at that boot. Howdy. It's adorable. She even has like little brads. Ugh, so cute. And on the back, you always put your information. Like, she named this one. This one's called Metamorphosis, and she did it in 313 of 17. This is number 188. It's pretty fancy how you do it. Isn't that neat? Love it. Okay, now then, and she sent me a letter. I'm not going to open the letter on camera, but look at that. I probably won't read your letters on camera. I think it'll be easier that way, and 90% of the time, you people make me cry. It's true, right?
Yep.
So I cry enough on live video that I don't want to cry anymore. So these are going to be the ones that we start with. Now I also have boxes and boxes of cards that have been sent to me over the years. And I will probably be pulling those out as well. But how fun. When we do our live show, we'll do a little segment and I'll share two or three of the ones that came in. I think it's neat. All right. That is today's live show. I just have one little update to tell you guys, and it's about next week. We won't do a live next Thursday because Thomas will be having surgery. My 16-year-old will be having ACL surgery next Thursday. So I can do it on Tuesday if you like. If you guys want me to change it to Tuesday, we can do a quick yes-no vote. And I can do Tuesday's video live. Just like we're doing this, we'll just move it up a day. And then Thursday, I'll just give you a pre-recorded video. So let's see what you say. There's a yes. Okay, so we can move it to Tuesday so we can still have our live next week. And any cards we get in between there can go on our, what do we call it, Inspiration Corner? Oh, we need to name it something that when we put it on the wall, it can be there too, so. Oh, I don't know. We'll figure that out. But each week I'll share some. So if you guys want to send it, and if you want our address, I tell you what, if you want our address, check out our, in the description box below, and also check out our website. That's where our address is. The Crafty Cafe, that's cute. Tuesday works. Awesome. All right. I am going to have some. I don't want anybody to think that I'm going to be neglecting Tom. You know I'm not. I know y'all know that I'm not going to neglect him. But I'm saying, like, I'm going to pre-record some videos for while we're out because I don't know how long that'll be. I probably will have to take a day or here off, I would think. There's probably going to be, I'm not going to catch that deadline or get something done.
Well, and then the week after that, my dad's procedure, so.
Yes, and that procedure, we might be back by Thursday. If we're not, I'll let you guys know. But don't worry, I'll do pre-recordings if I can't. So what do you do with those cards? I'm going to hang those cards in our classroom as inspiration for folks. So if you want a card on my classroom wall, make it and send it. Thank you guys for praying for him. He is having ACL reconstruction. I saw somebody else say that. So thank you guys so much. It was pretty detailed what the doctor was telling us yesterday. So, but he's a tough cookie. If you know Thomas, he's the same one that cut the tip of his finger off last year, and we went through some surgeries and stuff then too. So he's the one.
He's high maintenance.
He is high maintenance. All right, guys. Oh, I forgot to say this. The thing I did different, this basket, I cut these at half an inch, and this one I cut at the 5/8 of an inch. So do what you want. See how they look a little different? So I just did them different. So can you see that now that I show you?
A lot of people have been making suggestions for what to call it, but I particularly like Kimber Creations, Across the Miles.
Oh, pretty. We could put that in vinyl above it on the wall, Across the Miles, and everybody's cards. Our Across the Miles segment. I like that a lot. Awesome. Okay,
A lot of people put suggestions in, but that one just kind of jumped out at me. I like that.
I like that a lot. Across the Miles. The reason I like that is because it'll be in our classroom, and if I call it the Crafty Cafe, we might actually want to have a Crafty Cafe someday.
Oh, Lord.
Please be praying for Vince's dad, too. He has surgery the first week of April. We'll let you guys know. We appreciate all your prayers. They mean so much to us. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right. There you go, guys. I think we showed you two cool projects in about 45 minutes.
Awesome
sauce. And I hope you enjoyed it. We love you guys very much. And we will see you on Tuesday next week. Mark your calendars because we're changing it. Tuesday of next week. We'll see you guys then. All right. Should I wait for somebody to say the word?
No, it's not nighttime.
It's not nighttime. But you think somebody else. We need a day word. Don't we? People know.
Thank you, Renee.
Thank you guys so much. There it is. Good night, John Boy. I love you guys. I'll talk to you again real soon.
Bye.